It's happening again. I'm Chef Rosy Rong and I'm taking over this episode. Today we're going to be making slow-cooked lamb with polenta, green sauce, and garlic spinach. We're going to finish with some peanut biscuits.
You guys have been wondering where I've been. I was outside.
Okay, so now that I got in the light, somebody messing with me, you know. Alright, anyhow, I'm Chef Rachel.
And we're gonna cook because we like it.
I've got my pan warming. Let me talk you through the ingredients. We're using superb blend spices. You can find this at any local supermarket. Our lamb is lamb osso buco. Lamb is very common. This one is from hotel foods. Osso buco is simply a cut of lamb. It's from the leg. That means we're going to get the nice marrow from the bone. I'm going to be cooking it with some mirepoix veg. That's carrot, celery, and onion. And then we're going to be finishing it off with this nice red cooking wine. Okay, let's check our pan. Pan is getting hot, so oil goes down. Okay, looking nice. Onion goes first. While the onions are cooking, I'm just gonna get my spices in order. We're gonna be using black mustard. We're gonna be using some fennel, some bay leaves, one stick of cinnamon, a little bit of star anise, ground coriander, ground cumin, a little bit of white pepper, and some paprika. Smelling good. We're gonna now add our celery. Now, the reason why I wait a minute before I add in each ingredient is that when you're cooking in a larger volume like this, every time you add an ingredient, the temperature of the pan goes down. So if you just keep adding and adding, you're gonna be cooking from a cold pan. So you need to give it a minute for the pan to heat up again. Okay, now in with the carrots. You can see the nice mixture we've got going on here. And this combination is called mirepoix. This is gonna be the basis of our aromatics. Okay, time for the spices. Fennel, black mustard, cumin, going all in with the cumin. Cumin and lamb are friends. Coriander. And then the hard spices we're gonna add a little bit later. That is smelling lovely, so aromatic. We're gonna give it a minute for the pan to do its work. Forget these two. This is white pepper. I'm using white pepper over black pepper because I find white pepper have a really nice mellow kind of floral taste. It's gonna go great with our lamb. And then here I'm adding a little bit of paprika. This is gonna give our stew a really nice kind of smoky flavor, and it's gonna give it a nice color as well. Okay, so now all our spices and aromatics are down. I'm gonna set this to the side and we're gonna start to brown off our meat. Okay, I'm gonna be browning off the meat in this pan here. Okay, now we're about to brown the meat. I'm gonna get an apron on because it can get a little bit messy at this point. So I'm gonna do this a batch at a time. In with a little bit of oil. Lamb is pretty oily, so you're not gonna need a lot. smelling good. I'm going in with the salt. Again, I'm using fine sea salt. I personally prefer fine sea salt over iodized salt because it has a nice natural flavor. It doesn't have that metallic tang from iodine. We're looking for a little bit of caramelization on the lamb, and then I'm gonna add it into our main pot and I'm gonna do the next batch. Look at the color on that. Okay, that's ready to go into the pan. You can see, you can add that together. Give that a good stir. Already looking very nice. We're going in with our next batch. Okay, this is ready now to add to the pots. I've just finished browning off all the meat. It's gone into our big pot. Time to add our liquid and bring it to a boil. I'm going in with water, and then I'm going in with our red wine from the Grape Vine. I'm now going to cover that and let that come to a boil, and then I'm going to stick that in our Instapot. Our stew has come to a boil, time to transfer into the Instapot. Okay, it's in the Instapot. I'm going to set it to slow cook for 4 hours. I'll see you back here in 3 to make our polenta and our garlic spinach.
You must try the newest professional dry cleaners on the island. Lavada's is offering a full range of dry cleaning and laundry services for all your personal clothing and soft furnishings. We also provide full dry cleaning and laundry services to villas, hotels, and restaurants with the latest technology in finishing and dry cleaning equipment using an environmentally friendly, odorless solvent. Try us. We guarantee that your garments will be cleaned and pressed to perfection. Lavada's, unmatched professional services.
I put on some water, it's come to the boil. Let's make polenta. I'm using this Valrico fine cornmeal. This is a great pantry staple, very versatile. I'm doing a 4-to-1 ratio of water to corn flour. In we go into the pan. Whisk out the lumps. I'm gonna add a pinch of salt. We're gonna let that boil up. And then we're gonna turn the heat down to a simmer. The key to making good polenta is all in the arm work. You gotta whisk, whisk, and whisk some more. So you can see right away there's a change in texture. It's getting a little thicker. So we're gonna turn it down. Be prepared to get hot and sweaty with this one. Once you whisk out all the lumps, you can switch over to a wooden spoon. If you have a cuckoo stick at home, you can use that. So the polenta is gonna cook for about 15 to 20 minutes. And then we're gonna finish it off with a little bit of butter. Okay, our polenta's been bubbling away for about 10 minutes. I'm gonna start to add the butter. This butter is from Becca. I'm gonna add one lump at a time. This is gonna give it a nice rich flavor and it's gonna bring a nice gloss to our polenta. If you've got a really long stick at home, you might use that one. What I'm looking for here is that as the polenta is almost finished, it's gonna start to pull away from the size of your pan. So this polenta, I had 1 cup corn flour, 4 cups water, and I'm gonna be adding 4 tablespoons of butter. Our last block here. And we can start to see there's a change in the texture. We can see the polenta starting to pull away from the sides. That means it's almost done. I'm gonna keep whisking this. See you back in a few.
Keep you and your family safe with Sol Gas. Here are some helpful tips to keep you and your family safe when cooking with Sol Gas. Never tamper with the cylinder and only use the Sol-approved regulator and a hose designed for use with LPG. Securely connect the regulator to the cylinder valve until it clicks into place and is properly fastened and secured. It is important to check the hose clips and the rubber hose to ensure they are in good working condition and properly secured. It is important to check your hose and regulator and change them as needed. Change your rubber hose every 2 years. Change your regulator every 5 years. If there are signs of damage to your regulator, contact an approved Sol Gas distributor or a Sol service station for replacement immediately. Safety first with Sol Gas.
Okay, while our polenta is bubbling away, let's quickly wilt some spinach. Let's check our pan is nice and hot. Add a little bit of oil. I'm gonna go in with a handful of spinach. You can see our spinach has gone nice and dark green and glossy. I'm moving it around the pan constantly to make sure that all the leaves cook evenly. Okay, time to add a little salt. Now, some people don't love the local spinach because it's a bit slimy, but if your pan is really hot when you put this with the spinach in, it's gonna take some of the edge off that slime. So our spinach is almost done. I'm gonna lower the heat and add our garlic. We want garlic to go at the end so it doesn't burn. Once I can start to smell the aromatics from the garlic, we know it's done and we can turn the spinach off. Checking on our polenta. It is ready. Okay, we can plate our dish. You can see it's pulling away from the sides. Like that. Beautiful. We're gonna start with a nice, healthy dollop of polenta. We're gonna add our side of wilted garlic spinach. Let's take our stew out from the slow cooker. You can see that it's cooked down nicely. Okay, we're gonna finish off with a hit of our green sauce. And there you have it. Slow cooked lamb with polenta, wilted garlic spinach, and green sauce. Okay, our main is done. Let's whip up a quick batch of peanut butter biscuits. I'm using another pantry staple, Swiss peanut butter. It's easy to have this around, and this biscuit recipe is just 4 simple ingredients. I'm going with 200 grams of peanut butter. This is all natural, so you might see a little bit of separation, which is totally normal. We're gonna use a fork and bring it all back together. Adding a bit of granulated sugar. We're adding a pinch of salt. We're gonna crack one egg. Mm-hmm. This recipe is great for kids as well. You can bring everything together using a fork. Use the fork to break up the major lumps of the peanut butter. As this is natural peanut butter, you will have some harder bits and you will have the oil sometimes separated. You'll notice that the consistency will start to change, and you're going to see this is really going to come together and it's going to form a dough that you're going to be able to shape with your hands. So you can see now it's gone from looking a little bit liquid to more like a dough. Okay. We're gonna roll these out into little balls and we're gonna bake them at 375 for about 10 minutes. Go in with clean hands. Yeah, these are gluten-free. There's only 4 ingredients. Once you've rolled them out, you can take a fork and just give it a little press down to give it a little impression. Now our biscuits are ready for the oven. I can smell our cookies already. Let's get them out the oven. Mmm, look at that. So they have baked up nicely. Okay, and that completes our meal. Just add a little glass of wine. Taria, for letting me take over your show.